The building material science division's testing lab was established to support research activities as well as service external clients such as construction industry, customers at the end point of projects. For instance, you would have an infrastructure project that has a consultant and the client. We are there to service both the consultant and the client in terms of the works and the materials used on site. We usually test bricks, cement mortar cubes to assess the quality of the cement produced, as well as steel members that go into reinforcements of buildings. We have a variation of clients. We've had walk-ins from people who are just building their houses at Block 8 or Extension 4, and they just want to make sure that the bricks they bought are as advertised or will stand up to the loads that are going to be imposed on the structure. In terms of impact, I would like to cite our SATCAS accreditation, because that's where the difference comes in comparison with other testing facilities in the country. SATCAS accreditation basically means that clients that come to seek services from us are ascertained of the competence of the personnel that work on their products, as well as the reports that come out of our lab will stand to scrutiny of international standards and best codes of practice. I would advise anyone who's carrying out an infrastructure project to scrutinize every material that is used in the project, because buying material is expensive, and establishing an infrastructure project is expensive. It is best to avoid having to go back and correct errors, and you do that by getting the best or what is specified by the structural engineers or the architects that drafted the original drawings. So it's best to follow what has been prescribed to avoid having to go back and correct or break down the building. To prospective students that would like to venture into either civil engineering or material science, I would encourage them to do so. You might think there are a lot of civil engineers and material engineers, but there are not so many, and most material engineers can be found in mines, but a few are still out there that can go into areas such as testing, manufacturing of paints and other chemical products.